I'll give you a quick example. And I'm certain, especially you in Canada here, mashallah alaykum, they have the prime minister. Huh? We ended up with Trump in America. That's another issue. But you are relieved here. But you and me were not faced with the situation the first immigrants of Muslims were faced with. Who I'm talking about? Ja'far. Those who went to Abyssinia and the Qurayshi sent Amr ibn al-As, a big negotiator, an expert, and he's a friend with the Nabis to bring them back to Mecca. And he stood out there and he said bad things about the Muslims. The Nabis in Najashi called Ja'far and the Muslim, what do you say about Jesus? Straightforward question, what do you say about Jesus? What do you say? Look, the consequence of his answer is to be brought back to Mecca for persecution, brothers and sisters in Islam. It's a serious consequence. He said, listen, we say what Allah and His Messenger say. Abdullah wa Rasul. He's the slave of Allah and His Messenger. That's what's written in our scripture, in our Quran, and that's what we're going to tell you. Look at this. When Ja'far compromised the message of Allah, like a lot of Muslims do now, would the Najashi have accepted Islam? One day Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Medina called upon his companions. Today a righteous man passed away. He's referring to the Nabis, Najashi, the one who was confronted with the truth. If you really respect Christians, if you like them, tell them the truth, man. Don't shy away from the truth. Because you're afraid you're not going to be accepted. No. Tell the truth in a nice way. I'm not asking you to be mean. Absolutely. If you're going to be mean, don't tell it. Just be silent. But you got to tell the truth. You got to stand for what you believe in, brothers. That's your belief. That's the faith. You find in our religions a lot of things we're banned from doing to protect Tawheed. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one companion one day said to him, if Allah wills and you, insha'Allah wash. I said, no, don't say, why? He said, why? He made a mistake in a letter. But it could indicate shirk. He said, no, correct that. Say, insha'Allah, man, insha'Allah, hum, then. Don't say as, then. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we have a message for humanity. Regardless, wallahi, regardless of our situation. The Quran and the Sunnah teach us to give da'wah even if you are in the weakest of the weakest situations. Yusuf was in jail. He gave him da'wah. He was in the palace, he gave him da'wah. Regardless, our, don't say we're weak shape, we gotta survive here. And la ya akhi, tawheed must be intact. My salvation and your salvation is these. Don't let that tawheed go. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you the hadith ilahi, in Sunan al-Tirmidhi, hadith Anas ibn Malik, hadith Anas ibn Malik, radiallahu anhu, ya ibn Adam, O son of Adam, لو أتيتني بقراب الأرض خطايا لا تشرك بي. If you come in the day of judgment with earth filled with sins, with one condition, no shirk. توحيد لا إله إلا الله is intact, is there, is in place. And I want to tell you, لا إله إلا الله is made of negation and affirmation. نفي وإثبات. لا إله. You cannot believe that there is Allah and there is Jesus and there is Buddha and there is Huda and there is... Listen, I'm not asking you to be mean to those followers of this. No, but you have to believe in the depth of your heart without any shadow of doubt that salvation is in that kalima. And that kalima that you must remove the idea that there are other objects, other God, other created beings which can be considered gods, and you affirm the godship, you affirm al-uluhiyyah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله